Hi everyone! In this video, I'll explain how to create a form with Formaloo, how to track responses and leads, and how to organize the data. Let's get started. Firstly, let's go to Dashboard. To create a new project, click on New Formaloo and choose the form. Name the project. If you're not sure about it, you can always change it by double-clicking on it. You can also add the image by clicking on the icon displayed next to it. You are now redirected to the dashboard with a ready-made form to start with and result menus. The dashboard can be organized according to your preferences, and we will cover this in the video. However, firstly, let's edit our base. By clicking on Edit Base, you'll be taken to Editor to fully customize your form. Start by naming it and adding a description, logo, and cover picture. If you want to customize the text, simply select it and edit options will appear. You can delete fields from the template and start from scratch. Or another way is to use one of our templates and customize them. From here, add all necessary fields you'll need. You can do it by clicking on the plus icon and a menu of fields will open. You can choose from different ones like text, contact information, gathering fields, choice fields, rating and ranking, including CSAT and NPS scores, date and time, form structure, which contains fields to allow users to upload files and images on your form. The signature field allows users to sign the form before submitting it. And in other category, we have the hidden field, which is used to add some hidden values on your forms. If you'd like to see how the form behaves, for example, show some fields after a certain answer is selected. Choose the field and the logic tab will open. So let's say if the answer to the question, "Do you have additional comments?" is yes, then show the question, "Please let us know about it." Otherwise, hide. Then click on second question and choose after submit, go to ending page. It will take them to the default ending page, but more ending pages can be added as well. This is how the form will look like to submitters. Remember, the show-hide logic only appears to the classic forms, where all questions are visible on the same page. You can check your form type from the design tab of your editor. On the other hand, the one question at a time forms leverage the jump logic. Well, because each question is shown on a separate page, and the jump logic makes more sense in that case. The Design tab allows you to fully customize the form. You can choose how fields will be organized and if the titles will be shown. Then you also have design options to match the form to your brand image or choose preferred colors. We also have created default themes to choose from. If you'd like your form to have a background image, you can edit from here. Other customizing options are available from custom CSS. Check out the link to our help desk displaying the CSS we have for now. Let's go to the Notify tab. This tab allows you to send email notifications for yourself, your team, and even the submitters when the form is submitted. If you'd like to be notified as soon as the form is submitted, put your email in Receive Email Notifications and add another email to forward submit email to, so another person also gets notified once the form is submitted. It can be your team member, for example. From admin email template, you can either choose the default template or customize one on your own. Click on Add New Templates. It will take you to the editor where you can customize the text, insert your logo, and explore other features too. Make sure to name the template so you can use it for future. From the right sidebar, you can also customize the email's subject line. Add the form name so it can be used for that specific form. If you want your users to be able to reply to that email, insert the email their replies will be sent to. For email server, you have two options, either to choose Formaloo server or your own SMTP server. If you'd like to learn more about this, check out our video linked at the top right of the video. To share the form, click on the share button and you can simply copy the link. From here, you can also edit the ending of the URL and put down your custom domain for the form. To share the dashboard, click on the settings icon. If you want your dashboard to be available for anyone, go to public view and enable that too. It will generate a public address to the dashboard that you can share with anyone. For the form, you have different embed options like iframe, script, and even a chatbot. We are generating the code for you, so all you have to do is to copy the code and insert it in your website. It's that easy. Before embedding, you can also preview and see how it will look like on your website. You have different options to display the results. As mentioned before, the dashboard has already added a results page. However, you can also add menus and insert blogs as you wish. You can either insert them by clicking on the button or by typing the dash icon for quicker access. On the left side, you can manage menus. Add as many menus and pages as you need. Let's cover different data view options. A Kanban board is a dynamic project management tool that helps teams or individuals track and manage their workflow. It's structured into columns, and each column represents a different stage of the workflow, easily checking the status of different projects. You can sort and filter it from here. You can choose which columns and information will be displayed. It's like having a virtual command center where each client's tasks are visibly mapped out. To update the status of the card, just move it seamlessly. To have this, you need to have a single choice or the drop-down field in your form and call it status. That's how you can group your data. You can customize it by selecting Edit Base. As the name says, the table displays data within the table. You can filter by questions and decide what is shown here. From Sort By, you can add sort options. For example, whether some responses are going to be displayed ascending or descending. Once you click on the expand icon displayed next to a specific row, it will show you all the answers. You can also delete the row. However, it will not delete the response data, only the view of it on the table. The chart is one of the data blocks available in Formulus. It allows one to view tendencies clearly. As with other data blocks, this can also be fully customized, with an option to change colors as well. Just like Kanban, Gallery View is more advanced since you must specify which fields you want to show on the board's cards and which field you want your data to be grouped by. Sharing options can be found on the top right side of your dashboard. Once you click on Share, you will be able to customize the link and also set up your own custom domain of the app. If you've previously added members to your workspace, Access Management lets you control who has access to what data. Learn more about this from our workspace video. Enter their email and define their access level. You can also remove them anytime. To share your app's access with your audience outside your team, you can turn it into a portal by enabling a portal mode. This way, either you can add users manually or by clicking on Settings. If you disable this option, only users who have been manually added by you or your team can log into the portal. You can also enable desired options such as CAPTCHA and allow users to log in via OTP. Users may get your dashboard and access the pages they have access to when you give them the public link. The users of the table you select can use the same login credentials to access your dashboard. This enables you to make a straightforward single sign-on table for your portal and apply the same login and registration table to several no-code dashboards. Once you turn it into a portal, it becomes like an online hub where members can interact, obtain information, and participate in occasions or activities associated with the organization. Team members will need to have a Formulu account, but others can create accounts just for Portal. At the top right, you can watch our video about creating portals with Formulu. If you want to create a CRM, this is the best place to do it. You can either create one from scratch or use one of our templates. In the future video, we will cover how to create and manage a custom CRM. Thank you so much for watching the video. I hope you found it useful, and make sure to subscribe to Formulu for more tips, and happy Formuluing!